61A, lecture number 22. Announcements. The ANTS project is due Friday, but please complete phases 2 and 3 by tomorrow, and get an early submission bonus point by submitting everything by Thursday. Homework 6 is due Thursday as well. It's not very long, but it's important to help make sure that you're ready for the upcoming midterm, and so it does have a reasonable number of problems, although we've made a few of them extra so that you don't have to complete them all for credit. If that's not enough, there's the completely optional CATS contest. Midterm 2 is next Wednesday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. in various locations across campus. Please read the Piazza post describing logistics and to request any kind of alternate seat or location or time, fill out the form making that request by Friday. The exam covers material through today's lecture. Wednesday, Friday, and next Monday will be various examples and chances to review, but they don't introduce new content. And Pamela's in-person office hours are canceled today. Today's lecture on efficiency, for the first time, deals with the question of how fast programs run. Most important characteristic of a program is that it actually compute what it's supposed to compute correctly, and that's been our focus throughout the course so far. But another important characteristic is that do so without taking too long or using up too many resources, such as the amount of memory that's available on your computer. Those are concerns of efficiency. And while I don't think they're as important as correctness, they certainly are critical to making software that's useful for people. It's not going to be a focus of this course to write very efficient programs. In fact, that's a major focus of 61B. But beginning to develop an understanding of how different implementations affect the performance of a program is important to start with now. So we'll spend some time measuring how much work needs to get done in order to compute a result under different implementations today, and we'll learn just a little bit about the theory of computational complexity, which is further developed in courses like 61B, CS70, and especially CS170, an upper division course on efficient algorithms and intractable problems.